Hi there everyone, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for coming back. In today's video, I will be talking about the disidentification from the mind. I will be going through my own personal experience, like how I managed to disidentify from the mind and how I managed to come over my anxiety and depression and how I am here today where I am on this spiritual journey. But first and foremost, if you guys have not watched the previous video I uploaded yesterday, make sure you go do that first, because I actually spoke about a lot of important things that you would need to hear in order to understand what I'm going to be talking about here today. Here we are. This is the second episode, second video on the spiritual journey that I'm on. And I'm very excited for you guys to hear more about it. And I'm very excited to help you guys out, because I do think that everyone deserves to live the way I do right now, because it is just the only way to live. As soon as you experience it, there's no other way. As I had mentioned before, I am going to be talking about the mind itself. So your mind is very, very powerful. It's a great tool to have, but if you identify yourself with it too much, that can be really bad for you. And that can cause things in your life that you definitely don't want. So I'm here to tell you how to disidentify from your mind and how to not engage with your thoughts too much, how to not overthink too much. So when the first thing that you will need to do is just to realize that this up here is just a part of your consciousness. It is just an instrument, okay? So when the instrument is not tuned in properly, then you won't be able to use it. It's just like a guitar. When a guitar is not tuned in, you won't be able to play it, you know, it just won't sound good. So when your mind is not in tune, then it won't be performing the way it should be performing. Now, here's the thing, like, how do we make sure that your mind is in tune? As I said it before, you need to make sure that you realize that you are not your mind. You're so much greater than your mind. If I had to use a metaphor, I would use the ocean. So the ocean is very deep. We all know that, right? But it also has ripples on the top, some waves, ripples, you know? And your mind represents those ripples. So your consciousness is so deep, and there's so much to explore, just like in an ocean. But most people are stuck on the surface, or stuck on these ripples, and they keep just like riding these waves, riding these ripples, and they keep just going alongside with one of these ripples, and they hop into a different one, and it keeps going on and on, and they can never stop. It is like a circle. You can never get out of it unless you realize that's not who you truly are. So when you realize that you're far greater than just this up here, this little tool you have, this organ, because we have so many organs in our body, and it is kind of foolish to think that this organ would be able to take over your whole consciousness. Thinking that this up here is you, is your true nature, is your true self, is very insane. It's an insane way to live. And here's the thing with the mind. Your mind will always be wanting more. It will never be satisfied. If you live on the surface level of your consciousness, which is the mind, then you will never be satisfied in life. You will never achieve the things you wanted to achieve, because you will not realize that you had already achieved them. You know, you will always be wanting something more. It's your ego, it's your unconscious self. So this is the conditioned mind up here. And there's also an unconditioned field of your consciousness that has not been explored yet. And here I am today to help you with this, to explore this field of consciousness a little better, and just be able to let that consciousness live through you and let that consciousness guide you through your life. It's very simple. Let's just look at the phrase human being. So there's a human, the form, and there's the being, which is formless. So it's all who you are. There is the form, the shape of form that you're in right now, that consciousness is living inside of this body that you're in right now. Just think about one of your pets, or think about one of your relatives. What happens when that animal or when that person passes away? Will you still be able to love that person for just their physical body when the consciousness is gone, when there's nothing inside of that body? Will you still be able to do that? Well, the answer is obviously no. And the reason for that is because your consciousness is literally the beauty of you. Your consciousness is literally all who you are. It's experiencing itself in a body, a physical body, at the moment, but we all know this is temporary. And it is kind of an insane way to live, to not to acknowledge that this body will not last forever. And a lot of people live that way. A lot of people do not acknowledge the fact that this body will not last forever. This body will not serve you forever. Your body is mortal. I have to say it out loud. Probably all of us know it, but you have to acknowledge it too. The only immortal thing that you have within you, it is the consciousness that is literally flowing through me and putting the words out there right now. So I'm gonna leave it on that note. Just by watching this video and just by engaging in content like this, there's a seed that's being planted in you, and it will blossom out. It will start blossoming. That's the great thing about it. I wouldn't tell you this if I didn't go through the same thing, but I did. So in my next video, I will be helping you how to stop overthinking and how to actually put this in practice. So if you don't want to miss that video, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. I will see you next time. Take care.